Welcome to RG Geek. So I haven't seen any other videos covering the Atari 7800 on the RG350M. So I thought I'd show a bit of playthrough here. And let's start with Asteroids. The Atari 7800 is an interesting console because it only has a library of about 60 games for it. So you can pretty much play everything. I should do that in a video once. Long play all the Atari games. Feels great. So, anyway, I think you got an impression of this now. Unfortunately, the power button doesn't work in this emulator, but you can go out here, exit. Back to simple menu. I have 6.1 installed. And let's look at Choplifter. And obviously every game I've played so far has worked perfectly, except for Water Ski, which just wouldn't play. Doesn't surprise me too much, as Water Ski was one of the rarest games. We actually got it. But I haven't heard anything about it besides in our collection of cartridges. Let's kill the tank. Boom. There we go. Let's not kill any of these people. Sounds not perfect there, but it's okay. Aha, let's return these hostages. Anyway, you get the idea. So let's switch to another game. This is also a, this was an Atari 7800 exclusive, Desert Falcon. Thought it was interesting. So you can tell the audio is not perfect, but it's very, very playable. Should run to a building and hear that sound. Really picking this up though. Get three hero! Alright, let's run into this building. Oh. Alright, let's look at another game. Let's look at Food Fight, another classic of the Atari 7800. It also plays great. I set mine up so the left trigger button is B and the right trigger button is A. That's the most logical for these games. Usually you don't have to push A very often even. I mean, the I fix the sound on here. Haven't looked too much into that. Sound never bothered me that much. It's good enough to me. Two more games I want to show you. I'll show you now. Hat Trick. A great hockey game. Still got it. Ah. But I played the arcade version of this and it feels like the computer's cheating all the time when you start winning. It's not the case in this version. What I remember, I'm just losing. Doesn't actually seem like it's reacting very well. Oh, it's gonna be close. Oh no! Ah! Buzzer beater. Now, the final game is actually my favorite. Actually, the game I play the most on this system, Pole Position 2 for the Atari 2800. Usually, the sound isn't this bad. I'm gonna try going back in again. Actually, I've had this before. Sometimes the sound is bad when you go in the emulator, and you play it, and it's fine. So, that could have been what's happening. I also find this is the best version if people want to start trying to play Pole Position, because it's one of the most forgiving ones. I remember experiencing this many sound issues when I normally play. I wonder if I'm just enjoying the game and I don't even notice them. I notice them when I shoot. Oh, you know, it also could, because I don't usually play the game this loud. I'm playing it specifically loud today. So I'm betting that's it. I'm gonna try to crank down the volume and see if I still hear this interference. That's worse. Weird. That was dumb. Thinking about the sound, not thinking about my game. So anyway, I think you get a good feel of the Atari 7800 on the RG350M. I have links in the description if you want to buy it. I don't get anything from it, but if you're in Europe, there's a discount code for you for one of the vendors I recommend. So you can check that out. Just enjoying this little device so much. So, if you like this video, please like it. Subscribe if you want to see more content like this. And share it with your friends. Thanks. Oh, just missed. All right. Have a good one. Ooh.